Hello everyone, I am Pragati Jha Parasar. I am from Hooghly Mohsin College and I am legal intern of Lexis & Company. In this video, I am going to describe about the charge. So what is charge? So basically charge is defined under the CRPC. In the term charge means informing the accused about their offences. Charge is basically defined section 2B of CRPC 1973. So charge include any head of the charge when the charge contain more than one heads. So V.C. Shukla versus State, in this case it is said that charge should be properly maintained in the charge if any offences is made by the accused, it should be written in the law language and proper notice should be given to the accused. So what are the sections deals with the charge? Section 211 to 214 deals with the content of charge. Section 216 to 217 deals with the power of the court to alter the charge. Section 218 deals with the basic rules. Section 219, 220, 221 and 223 deals with the exception of the charge. Section 224 deals with the effect of withdrawal. Section 215 and 464 deals with the effect of error. In this video, I mostly explain the basic point of the charge. So, form and content of the charge. Under section 211 of the CRPC constitute the essential element of the content of charge. Number one is the charge form shall state the offences for which the accused is charged. In the content of charge, we should mention the offence which is to be done by the accused. Number two is that the name of the offence which is done by the accused should be mentioned in the charge sheet. Number three, in case there is no specific name in given, then the definition of offence should be mentioned in the charge sheet. The law and the provision, the law to be mentioned in the form. So the charge shall be written in the language of the law of the court, and the accused shall be informed about his previous allegation which would expose him to enhance the punishment and if found guilty for the offense charge. So in the case of Mohsin versus Sankaru, the court held that mere mentioning of section under which accused is charged without mentioning the substance of charge amount to the serious breach of the procedure. That means we have to explain the offence which is done by the accused. If it is not done, if it is not mentioned properly, then it is called the breach of prohibition, breach of procedure, etc. So, in the case of Dalchand versus the State, the court held that the defect in charge vitiates the conviction. So, this is all about the content of charge, means proper name, offence details, and proper details should be given if the offense does not come under the heads, then offense definition should be mentioned. So if it is not properly followed, then it is called the breach of procedure, which is already mentioned under the case. So section 212 of the CRPC assert the charge form shall contain the offense for which accused is charged and the particular like time, place and the person against whom it is whom the offense is committed, and giving to the accused the precise and clear notice of matter. That means under 211 said that what should be offenses details and what should it is necessary to give the notice to the in the court of language that what offense has to be done by the accused. But in the 212, it is necessary to maintain in the charge sheet the name, place and against whom the offence has to be done should be mentioned. Exact time need not be mentioned in the charge from when the accused is charged with criminal breach of trust or dishonest, misappropriation of money or any other mobile property. Exact timing is not essential, but it is necessary to give some estimate time also. In the Ranchod Lal versus State of Madhya Pradesh, it was held that failure to mention the particular precisely due to the nature of information may not invalidate the proceeding. Means if anyone fails to give the time, that means it is not give the proper failure of proceeding. under section 213 of CRPC asserted that when the nature of the case that particular mentioned the section 211 and 212 do not give the accused sufficient notice of the matter with which he is charged, the charge shall contain such particular of how the alleged offense is committed as will be the sufficient for this purpose. So this is about that time, name, against whom the offense has done, offense full details, and if it is not possible, then give the particulars how the offense has to be committed. It should be mentioned in the charge sheet. Then next is 216 of the CRPC, that is alteration of the charge. The trial court and appellate court may either alter or add the charge, provided the only condition is that the accused has not faced charge for new offense. Accused must have given opportunity of meeting and defending the charge against him. Alteration and add can be done, but it is necessary to see that no new offense has to be added, and proper defending right should also be given to the accused. Then after such alteration or any addition made to the charge, the charge shall be explained to the accused and prepared to meet the fresh challenges. If any addition and alteration has to be done by the any court, then proper chance and proper enable the accused to face the challenge. So this is all about the charge, an important section of the charge. So the charge means it is necessary to inform and to give the proper notice, proper by following the law language and giving the proper details of the offense, and sometimes describe the offense definition also, and give the proper heads also, and name, time, place should be mentioned. Time should not be accurate. It is not necessary that time should be accurate. It can, but this is all about the proper how to give the notice to the accused in the charge format. Thank you.